The Breaux Show was filmed before absolutely no audience whatsoever.
I've been expecting you. My name is Sergeant Slaughter, special drill instructor for G.I. Joe. You're going nowhere, Space Case. Jump, Yardbird! My job is to whip you into shape, and I'm talking whip. You're going to war till you wish you were dead, and then keep going, because you're afraid if you don't, I won't let you die. That's better.
It's time for the Hive of the Night, the Breaux Show! And now, here's everybody's favorite two-steppin' host, Michael Breaux!
Hi there, folks. Welcome to today's show. The Sarge is helping me. I can stop. Oh, thank goodness. The Sarge is helping me get prepared for better shows later this year. Because, you know, we got Thanksgiving and Christmas and October with Halloween and everything. So we're trying to get in shape for better shows for you guys. He saw last week's show and said it was a little sloppy. I know. I'll do it Slaughterhouse style next time, I promise. Anyway, thanks for everybody coming back to watch us after we were gone for such a long hiatus. I promise I won't watch Farscape that long again, ever again, because he'll kick my butt. Anyway, we've got a great show for you today. We've got a lot to look at, a cool new toy review, and the mention of the contest that we did, that we talked about last week. I'll give you the full rules at the end of the show. That being said, we'll be right back after this. What? More? Shower. Oh, I can hit the showers. Thanks, Sarge. All right. We'll be back after this.
My name is Darth Vader. I am an extraterrestrial from the planet Vulcan. By order of the Vulcan High Council, I order you and all Earthlings to go to RetroCon. It is a celebration of all things pop culture. It is to be held on Sunday, November 11th, 2012, at the Greater Philadelphia Expo Center in Oaks, Pennsylvania, planet Earth. Features include action figures, video games, memorabilia, replica props, door prizes, a costume contest, special guests, a live DJ, and much, much more. Even my very spaceship will be in attendance. So go, prepare now for RetroCon, or I will melt your brains. And sorry about your barn.
All right, folks. Wow. Whew. I feel much better after that workout this morning. Woo-wee. I mean, I went crazy running out there for the Sarge there. Sergeant Slaughter, he decided to come over and help me out and whip me into shape for the show. I don't know why. I guess he figured I needed to be a little bit less sloppy. I don't know. I can't help it. I'm the Breaux Show. I can't help it. I'm a little sloppy. I mean, the shows aren't perfect, right? They don't need to be, right? Anyway, I hope you guys enjoy me rerunning that spot for RetroCon again. I'm probably going to run it every show between now and when RetroCon comes up, November 11, 2012, simply because we really want to see everybody go there. We want to see all the Bro Patrol go to the RetroCon and enjoy themselves. It's going to be so much fun. We can't wait to be there. That's myself and my executive producer, Ms. Bro. And any fans of the show, please come on up. Bro Patrol, support RetroCon. That being said, let's get right into our two-minute toy review for this week. We're going to be taking a look at a bot, one-eyed bot with a one-track mind, the Fall of Cybertron version of Shockwave here. So let's take a look right now.
In this week's two-minute toy review, we take a look at the new video game and Cybertronian version of a certain single-eyed Decepticon. Let's take a look at the purple powerhouse and cold methodical terror known as Shockwave. Just a few weeks prior to the Fall of Cybertron video game release, Shockwave here started to appear on Target and Toys R Us store shelves, giving us a sneak peek at the one-eyed terror. The front of the card back features great artwork from the video game itself of Shockwave in robot mode on the card back and vehicle mode on the front bubble, along with a little bit of himself in robot mode and the arm cannon on the side. The card back features pictures of Shockwave in both modes, along with a small bio and a tech spec set that is harkening back to the old days of G1 tech specs. That's a nice touch for those of us who grew up in the 80s. So how is Shockwave when he isn't minty fresh on card? Let's find out. Unlike his original incarnation as a ray gun, this version of Shockwave has him as a menacing little tank. I stress little because, as like the other Fall of Cybertron figures, he has lost some scale in the size department, but not detail. Menacing still comes to mind, however, when looking at the tank mode with the large cannon in front with pink highlights, attack fins coming out all over it seems, and what clearly is the chest of Shockwave as part of the upper turret or control center. With a deep purple color with silver and clear purple highlights, this tank looks awesome, even if it is small. Now let's see about getting this tank to say, "I am transformed." First, pull down and away the back black thrusters, and then pull them apart as shown. Second, separate the two back halves of the tank, and then rotate them downward to become the shoulders. Fold out the hands as shown, and leave them to the side. Now fold forward and around the center control tower for the tank to become Shockwave's chest, and when locking into place, his head will pop on out. Lock the shoulders into the chest as shown, fold the side wings up into the back of the chest area, and fold the arms down, while rotating the elbow joint for the hands to face forward. Next, fold the sides of the legs from the hips to the lower leg and lock into place as shown, and rotate the feet up. Split the legs apart, remove the cannon from Shockwave's rear quarters, and place the cannon in his hand. Shockwave is now transformed. So Shockwave in robot mode. Well, can he move well? Shockwave has a head that goes side to side only, or up and down if you count that too. Arms with shoulders that go up and down, slide up and out, and weirdly double-jointed elbows. No waist swivel. Ball and socket hips. Knees that bend and have swivel knee battle kick. And toes that point up and down. Overall, a great range of motion and a sturdy foot base with the oversized back heels here. My one big complaint initially was the gun being only held in place on the peg in his hand. Then I saw an update Optibotomus did to one of his reviews a bit ago, and he showed this. Fold the hand in and place the arm cannon in and on it at this point. Voila! Instant cool-looking arm cannon. Also of note is that the end piece slides off to reveal three puny-looking guns. This slides off really easily, so be careful when posing Shockwave's arms. It might fly off. Lastly, as cool as Shockwave looks, he is a little shorter than the other comparable Generations and Classics figures, but not by much. So what's the bottom line? Shockwave is a definite must-own for any fan of the G1 line and the Classics/Generations line of Transformers. I only wish he was a head taller so as to match Cybertron Megatron's height. But that's a minor issue. The coolness factor of having an arm cannon that fits so well into his bot mode and then looks so evil in tank mode outweighs any height issue, and Shockwave is just plain awesome. For around $12 to $15 at retail, Shockwave is well worth the purchase. The question now is, when will Radio Shack sell their own new version of Shockwave?
What can I say? Very cool Transformer. I just wish he was a little bit taller. I mean, Megatron shouldn't exactly tower over him. They should be about the same size. And I did wish that this didn't fall off so easily, but still, he's a very cool figure. I do enjoy him. You gotta wonder, though, does he have any actual peripheral vision whatsoever? Probably not. And if he had to wear glasses, would it be just a monocle? Something to think about. We'll be right back after this.
This week in Geektastic History.
This week on September 2nd, 1969, the very first ATM, or automatic teller machine, went into use in Rockville Center, New York. Set up for Chemical Bank, this ATM could only dispense cash to its customers, but by 1971, ATMs were being used to handle multiple transactions, including showing people their balances on accounts. An executive from the automated baggage handling company DocuTel by the name of Don Wetzel is the man who was mainly given credit for coming up with the idea for the ATM while waiting in line for the bank. From that small idea through today, there are over 1 million ATMs across the world, even at a remote station in Antarctica. So next time you're at a toy convention and needing cash, remember that it's better to wait at an ATM in a hotel lobby than one down south, way down south in Antarctica.
This week in Geektastic History.
All right, folks, that's it for this week's show. Thank you for coming on by. Now, last week I teased about a contest we're going to be running, so here's the skinny on that contest. It's for really all you artistic types out there. Basically, the Breaux Show, we have our official shirts here, the Breaux Show for thebreauxshow.com, the Breaux Show, myself, my executive producer, staff of the show. However, we don't have anything really for the Bro Patrol out there. Now, I call my fans Breaux Patrol for a reason. It was coined a long time ago, 15, almost 20 years ago, by my best friend Tiger, back when I did the original Breaux Show as a student production. And he called all my friends and family and everybody Breaux Patrol. So it just kind of stuck, and I really like it. Now, I would love to have that design or that name into a design that's great for like a t-shirt or maybe for a hat or maybe for wristbands, something like that. So I'm looking for you, fans of the show, to actually help me design that look to put on a t-shirt, to put on hats, to put on wristbands, whatever really, maybe a coffee mug, basically anything that CafePress.com can do. We do have a Cafe Press store. We actually put it on the Facebook page several months ago, but haven't seen the activity out of it, and I'd really like to see people get something that's made for them. So fans, artistic types, anybody who can put pencil to paper and draw, then take a picture and send it to me. That's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for you to design to have really cool, like, rock and roll design, like those really cool rock and roll t-shirts with intricate designs and veins and maybe spikes and things like that, something that's really rocking with the words Breaux Patrol in it or the Breaux Show. Either one will work, but I really want to see something that says Breaux Patrol on it. That would be very, very cool. Now, the deal is we're looking for submissions between now and September 21st. Friday, September 21st. You can email them to me at host@thebreauxshow.com or go to the Facebook page and send me a message with an attachment there. I don't want to show off these quite yet. Now, my executive producer and I, my wife and I, are going to take a look at these designs, and then on Monday, September 24th, we'll put a poll up on the Facebook page that anybody can vote on, that all the Breaux Patrol can vote on, and voting will be open for 1 week through October 1st. On October 1st, voting will be closed, and whoever's design wins will get their design put onto a shirt at Cafe Press that anybody that's a fan of the show can order, or put on a mug, or put on wristbands, or put on a hat. I really want this to be something that's designed by Breaux Patrol, for Breaux Patrol, and for fans of the Breaux Show. Now, all this will be on our website, thebreauxshow.com. All the details will be there, also on the Facebook page and on our Twitter page. There'll be a link to all these as well. Needless to say, I really want this to be about you. I want you to design it. I want you to come up with it. And let's make it fun. I know I've got a few people out there that are fans of the show that are a little bit artistic, that can draw a lot better than me. I basically do stick figures. That's it. I'm no good at drawing. So I'm looking for you guys to help me out with this. So what do you think, Breaux Patrol? Can you come up with a cool design that says, "Rock on, Breaux Patrol," for us? I'm hoping you can. That's it for this week's show. Wait, oh, hold on. Oh, no. Oh, no. Sarge, really? You're going to make me work out again? He's saying that he's going to make me work out again, folks. Yeah? Oh, God. I gotta start running. Okay, guys. That's it for this week's show. Thank you for coming on by. Remember, enjoy the show. Come back next week for more reviews, more toy fun, and as always, rock on, everybody! I got a show to do. I know you don't care. I got to do the show. Later, guys. That's it. Have a good day, everybody. Rock on!
Jump, yard bird!